वेलकम टू ऑल द स्टूडेंट्स इन न्यू एकेडमिक ईयर इन विद्युत बोर्ड विद्यालय। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल कांग्रेचुलेट्स टू ऑल द स्टूडेंट्स हु आर गेटिंग अ गुड मार्क्स इन 10th एंड ज्वाइनिंग 11th साइंस। रियली साइंस हैविंग थ्री पार्ट्स, केमिस्ट्री, फिजिक्स एंड बायो। सो दोज स्टूडेंट्स हु आर ऑप्टिंग ग्रुप बी, they have to be select chemistry, physics and bio. And those students who are selecting group A, physics, chemistry and mathematics. So, either in group A, either in group B, chemistry is the common subject. And today, we'll start the first chapter of chemistry, which is quite related with your 9th standard, 10th standard and miscellaneous exercise of the science. Really, the first chapter of the 11th chemistry, chemistry in chemistry in everyday life, that is to say basic concept of chemistry. We all are depends upon different type of matter. Our basic requirement and daily requirement is food, protection and housing. Basically your matter either in the solid state, either in the liquid state, either in the gaseous state. Your matter either may be element, either may be compound, either may be mixture. So basically, first we are discuss about the matter. Matter, anything having mass and occupied space is called matter. Basically, matter was first identified by Antoni Lavoisier. That's why Antoni Lavoisier was called as father of chemistry. So who is the father of chemistry? Antoni Lavoisier is the father of chemistry. Basically, matter was first identified by Antoni Lavoisier and stated that matter neither be created, neither be destroyed. It can be changed from one form to other. You all are know, we can convert solid ice into water by changing its thermal energy. We can convert water into gas by changing its thermal energy. Means matter are transferable with each other. Solid converting to liquid, liquid converting to gas. So basically, matter on the basis of physical property, matter on the basis of physical property it is classified into three class: solid, liquid and gas. On the basis of chemical property, matter classified into element, compound and mixture. Again, mixture is of two type: homogeneous and heterogeneous. So, on the basis of physical property, matter classified into three class: solid, liquid and gas. You all are know the difference between the solid, liquid and gas in lower standard 9th and 10th. Solid having fixed shape and fixed volume. Liquid have fixed volume but undefined shape. Gas, undefined shape and undefined volume. This is the first and basic difference between the solid, liquid and gas. The first and basic difference between the solid, liquid and gas. Solid having fixed shape and fixed volume. Liquid having definite volume but undefinite shape. Gaseous component have undefinite shape and undefinite volume. Basically, the other difference between the solid, liquid and gas. Solid having strong intermolecular attraction between the molecule. Solid having strong intermolecular attraction between the molecule, while the intermolecular attraction in liquid, while intermolecular attraction in liquid slightly less as compared to solid, while in gaseous component intermolecular attraction between the molecules are very very less. It means that solid molecules quite compact with each other. Solid molecules are quite compact with each other, while liquid molecule have slight difference between each other. Gaseous molecule having large difference with each other. You know that solid cannot be compressed. Solid cannot be compressed. Liquid slightly be compressed. According to the experiment of the scientist, at 1000 bar pressure, it is quite difficult, no? Your atmosphere containing maximum 1 bar pressure. At hill station, at lower part of the earth, the atmospheric pressure is slightly decreased, slightly less, but at normal pressure, 1 bar pressure. So 1 bar pressure at the earth, and you have to be fabricate the pressure at 1000 bar, it is quite difficult. Impractical. So liquid at 1000 bar pressure and 20 degree centigrade temperature can be compressed only 4%. It means that this process is quite difficult. But I'm not saying liquid cannot be compressed. Liquid slightly compressed, but gaseous component. Gaseous component compressed. It means that gaseous molecules are slightly attract with each other. But according to kinetic molecular theory of gases, gaseous molecule cannot neither be attract nor repel with each other. I am not agreed 100% with the kinetic molecular theory of gases. But you know that liquefied petroleum gas, you know that compressed natural gas. So liquefied petroleum gas, compressed natural gas is a liquid component basically, which are compressed methane gas at a very high pressure, which compressed butane gas at a very high pressure, and they convert into liquefied petroleum gas and compressed natural gas, and they convert into liquid. But if you slightly open the knob, then the liquid converted into gaseous because they get space surrounding. So gaseous molecule can be compressed with each other. But the gaseous molecule can be compressed, while liquid and solid cannot be compressed. Liquid molecule slightly be compressed. So basically, the difference between the solid, liquid and gas, it is not so important for your basic concept of chemistry. But this is the part of the chemistry, that's why we discuss about the difference between the solid, liquid and gas. Basically, surrounding our us, matters either in the solid state, either in the liquid state, either in the gaseous state. In our day-to-day life, we have to be observed that the matter we used either in the solid state, either in the liquid state, either in the gaseous state, all the students are know, teachers also we know that our comfortable life depends upon the oxygen gas. Without respiration, no any living thing is survive in the country. So here, liquid, this is the basic component of our body. Maximum proportion of the body is liquid. Without liquid, our tissues cannot be survived at long time. That's why liquid and gas, with the water and oxygen, this is the basic component of our life. So basically, solid, liquid and gas are the classification of the matter on the basis of physical property. Next, we discuss about the classification of the matter on the basis of chemical property. On the basis of chemical property, matter are classified into element, compound and mixture. Element made up of identical type of atoms.
element made up of identical type of atoms. According to Dalton's theory, they cannot be divided. But atom of one element, when combined with atom of other element in a definite proportion, we get compound. Atom of one element, when combined with atom of other element in a definite proportion, we get compound. But remember once again, listen very carefully. If atom of one element combined with atom of other element in indefinite proportion, we get mixture. Slight difference. Remember us. Atom of one element combined with atom of other element in a definite proportion, we get compound. But if they combined in indefinite proportion, we get a mixture. So, you know, so many examples of the compound: water, glucose, sucrose, which are very important component of our basic life. They are the examples of the compound. Regarding the mixture, sugar in water, urea in water, glucose in water, sucrose in water, they are the very common example we are discussing today in our day-to-day life. They are the example of mixture. They are prepared by the indefinite proportion of the combination of the element. Mixture is of two types: homogeneous mixture and heterogeneous mixture. Homogeneous mixture is a type of mixture in which component cannot be separated easily. I'm not saying component cannot be separated. Component can be separated, but component cannot be separated easily. That's why, for example, suppose if you add sugar in water, can you separate sugar from the water easily? No. If you add sodium chloride in water, can you separate sodium chloride from water easily? No. But by the process of evaporation, by the process of fractional distillation, by the process of crystallization, you can separate. But for this process, you have to be required laboratory, you have to be required some of the apparatus which are not easily available in our home. So, I mean to say, homogeneous mixture cannot be separated easily. Example, sugar in water, urea in water, glucose in water, etc. Heterogeneous mixture. Heterogeneous mixture is a type of mixture which can be separated easily. For example, sand in water. If you added sand in water and shake the component continuously, the particles of the sand or particles of the soil are uniformly moved throughout the water. But if you once time stop your process, then the particles of the sand or the particles of water slowly and slowly deposited at the lower part of the solution. So what happens? Two components can be separated easily. One of the basic example we know, suppose if you convert iron into very fine powder form, if you convert iron into crush the iron into very fine powdered form and mixed with sodium chloride. Sodium chloride and piece of iron, both are mixed with each other. This is also be an example of the heterogeneous mixture. Can you separate iron from the sodium chloride? A very simple example you can say, yes, can be separate by the process of magnet. Magnet attract iron particle towards it, and sodium chloride cannot be attracted towards the magnet. You know why sodium chloride do not attract towards the magnet? Because sodium chloride is neutral, while iron is not neutral. In later on we discuss why iron is not neutral. In structure of atom, one of the very important chapter for the chemistry, and in the classification of element. But here, simply we know sodium chloride is a neutral, but iron is not neutral, and the magnet attracts iron particles towards it. Sodium chloride can be separated from iron very easily. But very small children, add a mixture of sodium chloride and water into sodium chloride and iron mixture into water. You know that sodium chloride dissolves into water, but iron not dissolve into water. By this way, we can separate the sodium chloride from water. This is one of the process. So this is a very little bit idea in the first session of the chemistry regarding the matter. I think and hope you all are know about the matter and you agreed with us. Thank you. We'll meet in second lecture. All the best.